Wolverine is coming out again.
Yeah, again.
Again.
He's coming back in a new movie. Coincidentally, we're tying in with that movie.
What? We are?
Yeah, we get some revenue from that too.
Let's do it then.
So I want to talk about the most revenge-filled badass ever. Who is that thing that I said? Number one, they, of course, have to have a perfectly tragic backstory that justifies their revenge.
Right.
Number two, they have to demonstrate moments of badassery in their righteous vengeance. And number three, they have to show that they are adequately haunted by their past.
Ooh, I'm your past.
There is no one better for this than the Wolverine, Logan James Howlett. This guy is consumed by such tragedy in his life, basically all based on puberty and how puberty sucks for everyone.
You grow claws in places they didn't have claws before.
Exactly. We've all been there, Dan.
Oh, I know.
It was worse for little James, though, because his life snowballed. It was every single person he met had to die. Every single friend he met had to betray him viciously.
But that keeps happening. You can't get revenge on something that's still occurring. With Kratos, who's the better pick, by the way, hence why I'm debating him, he gets in such a bloodthirsty, fueled rage while he's fighting a war, he accidentally kills his wife and child. I have those. I don't want to kill them. I don't want their charred, dusty remains permanently affixed to my body, constantly reminding me, you need to get revenge and kill some people.
I don't think that's why that was there, Dan.
I think it was punishment by the gods, even though it's kind of clear the gods orchestrated it to happen. Then he kills the guy who made it happen, and then he needs more revenge. Like, something happens, and then he can get revenge.
And it's continual again. I mean,
Wolverine is just, something bad happens. Yeah, but something bad happens. Something bad happens. Give me a moment to breathe. Kratos kills the Greek gods just in the most horrifying ways. He rips off their heads. He chops off their wings. He punched Zeus's face into pulp.
Sure.
Then I think he killed Zeus's ghost. He needed to double die. It's like KFC made a sandwich, and it was kill Zeus, chicken, kill Zeus. That's pretty delicious, and it's pretty badass.
I'd eat that sandwich.
I'd eat that sandwich, too.
So, my mom was badassery for Wolverine. As I mentioned, he's many. At one point, he gets caught in, like, an atomic-level bomb, and Wolverine's like, oh no, it's just Wolverine's adamantium skeleton, except for a drop of blood. And he regenerates from a drop of blood, and you're sitting there, like, you're watching his skeleton regenerate, and every little bit in his eyes pop in, and he's like, I'm glad my eardrums haven't come in so I can't hear the douche talking, because I'm gonna kill him! And then as soon as he's ready to go, in all of his naked glory, he starts, go, let's go! You know how many people he's killed while naked? Yeah. Not just kind of naked, but severely naked, Dan.
I want to talk about how Kratos is consumed constantly by his seeking revenge.
Fine.
He spends every single moment, once his wife and daughter become face paint, trying to kill Ares. He kills Ares, then the Greek gods betray him, so then he dies. He's like, no, I'm coming back. So he crawls out of hell,
sure,
making sure killing everyone in hell first. I don't know where you go if you die in hell. Then he's just random person. I'm gonna crush you so that I can get up this jumping puzzle. And the guy's like, dude, I have a family too! And he's like, no, too bad, crunch! And just everything about him has become so inhumanly devoted to his revenge that he's killing people that, like, he was probably protecting back before his revenge bout. Wolverine, he doesn't even remember who he's fighting for anymore because he's lived so long. He's like, no. Was this my sixth or my seventh wife that I'm getting revenge for?
After the House of M, he remembers everything, and it just hits him at once. So even though, if this would normally boil a normal person's brain and they would just then die in, like, a puddle of saliva, Wolverine's like, crap! I can survive withstanding this amount of trauma to my memories.
But he doesn't want to.
He doesn't want to, so he has to sit there, and he can't even get drunk because he can't drink himself to stupidity because his body is regenerating too fast. There is no escape. He can't kill himself. He can't just be a good guy because no one will let him be a good guy. He's stuck.
Murdering his wife.
He is stuck. Damned through rage, I seem to have torn off my clothing, but it did not regenerate. The point is, Wolverine is one of those characters that, despite the fact that he is nothing but hate and anger and rage and sorrow, we all love him. He is a character at the end of any Wolverine story, we love Wolverine. Kratos is really unsalvageable. We don't love him. We fear him.
Aphrodite loves him. I don't really believe that Wolverine is revenge bent. I think Wolverine is just really, really violent. Because you'll have episodes or issues where Wolverine's sitting there drinking a beer, having a cigar, flirting with Jean Grey. There's really never a moment like that with Kratos. Everything is dedicated to revenge. You never see Kratos just like eating a pita, like, I'll get to it after lunch. No, every moment he is on the clock. Even when he is banging the ladies, it's so that he can get through to the next part.
Or experience.
Or experience the blue orbs and the green orbs and what have you. Even though, debatably, your movie is going to be the best X-Men movie ever.
It is. It's so good. It's making me glisten with anticipation.
Oh my. It seems that Kratos has been deemed the best revenge-fueled badass.
Sure.
Mainly because Wolverine has many times tried to settle down, have another family.
I guess.
They do eventually get murdered, but at least he tries. Kratos,
right.
If he was offered a chance at peace, he'd probably say, I'll take a piece of your ass, and then just chop it off with his two blades and eat it.
So what's your final word on this, Dan?
My final word is, my name is Inigo Montoya. You forgot to debate me. Prepare to die.